Wait. You're not going anywhere.
You need to write Caesar. And Ingram is not going to leave this car in the hands of an ex-con who is about to leave the state and break parole. 44 hours and 59 minutes left. Let's go.
Okay. Maybe we can just ditch her at a gas station or something.
Hey, man, look, you wanna go on? I'll boom her ass out. Okay? Just follow me, dude. I'll have you driving like a bat out of hell. She'd be screaming to get out of this car.
She's just crazy, you know? She talks too much.
So a role like this, I always say that you're given something to do, and then it's you define an actor by how they play within that. This is a very reactive role. You have a lot of time where you're basically watching them drive, or you're reacting to them driving. So you have to find a sense of life to play there. What is that like? How do you do that and build the character out of a lot of silence in many cases?
Well, yeah, I mean, you've made an obvious, very interesting point, which is this is a movie about cars, so that's what people want to see. And I think the director wanted to really give the story some heart and do that by way of fleshing out the characters as much as he could. I think he was actually always into the idea of like having time, and like having the sense of like time is passing slowly despite the fact they're going so fast, you know. And I also thought that's quite an interesting idea that the characters could afford themselves those moments despite the rush to get to California. But yeah, I mean it's difficult in a film like this. It is hard, and you do come up against problems with trying to find as kind of dynamic a role as you can put together in this sort of scenario.
I think a lot of it just becomes about what's happened, you know, what happens between you and Aaron, and that's got to be a thing that you guys really, there's space there for you to really define it. It's not everything is so meticulously written. There's a lot of room for you guys to play that.
There was a lot of room, and also what lends itself so well to that is the fact that the cameras are right up in your face, you know, like right up against the car. So a lot of the film, a lot of the story is told through, you know, torso up and our faces. So you could afford to kind of make smaller choices in that way.
The actual driving, the getting into the, there's so much of it that has got to be just a kick to be there physically, because you are getting to do these things, and there's a lot of it that is you guys, like there's no mistaking it.
Yeah.
Were you a car head before this? Do you like cars? Are you into them before, or was this a new sort of kick to try?
Yeah, I really had no interest in cars. I don't even drive, so here's the thing, like, I get it. I'm crazy about stuff myself, and if someone's crazy about cars or video games, then that's great. But this guy, I'm sort of like, oh, it's, you know, it's kind of like a banana on wheels, and that's cool, but it's not really my bag.
I do want to ask you, I guess, on camera about the last name thing as we sign off, because you and I share something, a very special bond that most people can't understand. I'm Drew McWeeny.
I am Imogen Poots.
Yes. Is acting a way of, because you could have changed it, but you didn't, and I love that you didn't.
Yeah, it's because my dad's the greatest person in the world.
Yeah, because I went through a phase where I thought about it, and then I decided I love this, and I love that people never forget it after they hear it.
That's true, that is true. But also, I'm being serious, like, I would never, I'd never change my name just because, like, I love my family. They're like the best people I know.
Well, miss,
but it is ridiculous.
It's a real pleasure, and I enjoyed you in the film. I really
cool.
did.
Thanks a lot.
Nice to meet you.
For breaking entertainment news and more, follow @HitFix on Twitter or visit HitFix.com.